Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with our look at the U.S. stock market for Thursday, February 12th, 2015. In the pre-market this morning, both stock index futures and commodities are higher, so we are looking for a bump at the open on Thursday morning. Just starting off this morning with a little housekeeping. This is my last presentation of the week. Next time you'll hear my voice is next Tuesday morning. Now, we've been watching the S&P 500 cash index closely, made a high last week, and now we're seeing if we can take that out. Traded slightly above it yesterday. Looks like we're going to open above it this morning, and we'll have to see if we can close above it on Thursday. Looking at longer term, and remember, we're looking at two trading ranges here. So we're up at the top of the 2015 trading range. And if we can take that out, then we have to deal with the December trading range. To get there, we need to break out above the November high, which is 2075.76. And then you can see on the December high, that was up at 2093.55. Now, if we can take that out, there's going to be psychological resistance at 2100. Then 2125 is our next mathematical target. Later in the presentation, we'll split this up and take a look at our next hourly targets for the S&P 500 cash index. Let's move on to commodity ETFs, and we saw the commodity tracking ETF make its way all the way down to the lower channel line. A close on Thursday below 1763 would give us a sell signal. Not expecting that to happen since commodities are up in the pre-market this morning. Copper, which traded lower yesterday, the futures contract is sitting right on the lower channel line, but the ETF actually closed below the lower channel line, so we're back on a sell signal there. That would change on Thursday with a close above 3066. Looking at gold is up in the pre-market this morning, certainly not enough to give us a buy signal. You can see to get to the upper channel line, we actually have to break through an open gap here. But the upper channel line is at 121.21 on Thursday. That is going to continue to move lower until gold intersects with the upper channel line. Platinum, similar situation. We need to close above 119.99 on Thursday. Certainly not going to get that. And for silver, we're looking for a close on Thursday above 1663. Looking at crude oil, it traded through the lower channel line yesterday, but did not close below it. So on Thursday, we're looking for a close below 1823. What we're seeing in the pre-market this morning, it looks like it's going to make up for yesterday's loss in crude oil. And we've got gasoline trading at the upper channel line. Natural gas is back on a buy signal, so a sell signal for the bear and a buy signal for the bull. Looking at the bull ETF, you've got several targets. Mathematical target doesn't come in till over $6, but we do have the January high at 543, and then above that, you've got the bottom of the open gap. So those are your next two targets to the upside for natural gas, if we can get a trend going here. Next up, let's look at the stock market and the VIX for the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ still on sell signals, no change there. There is the Dow, didn't take out last week's high yesterday, pretty close to an inside day there for the Dow. There's the S&P 500 poking its head just slightly higher. The NASDAQ leading this market higher. It still has the December high to deal with. And then we've got the Russell and the ZAX micro cap. So the broader market, small cap, mid cap stocks had an inside day on Wednesday. Bank stocks still on a buy signal there. We had energy stocks trade into the channel yesterday, closed at the upper channel line. And so we're still on a buy signal there, no change in trend. Gold stocks continue to move lower on Wednesday. We saw semiconductors continue to move higher and transports still hugging the upper channel line, but still on a buy signal. So no change in trend there for transports. Next up, let's take a look at a couple of the most actively traded U.S. stocks, starting with Bank of America, traded down to the upper channel line yesterday. Still closed above it. A close below 1584 on Thursday would give us a sell signal. Not expecting to see that. We've been watching Ford closely lately. It was stuck up at the recent high here from late November, and it looks like it's broken out. So we're looking for a move up to 1641. If you're trading Ford, then you want to have an order in the market up at 1641 to lock in some profits. Apple Computer continued to move higher. Remember, we were stuck at 1875. That was a profit target for us. Next profit target was previously 125. We got up just under that yesterday, got as high as 124.94. So we should be able to hit that today. Now, since we spent time treading water at the 118.75 level, we now have a new target between 118.75 and 125. And so, you know, that target just showed up because we were trading sideways. I am still using the 125 target to lock in some profits up here in Apple Computer. Once I've taken some more profits off the table, then I'll hold the remainder of my position until we get kicked out. We would get kicked out on Thursday with a close below 117.46. Don't expect that to happen. And that lower channel line will continue to move higher daily. Next up, we're looking at Sirius. Remember, Sirius was stuck at the 361 level for a couple of weeks, and then we had 371 and 381. 381 was two lines up. We hit that yesterday, so if you had orders in the market, those orders should have got filled on Wednesday. Last up this morning, quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. There's the VIX. The VIX, there was a pressure zone. We started to move up, couldn't get through the open gap. New early warning signal. We're coming back down, looking to see if we can take out the recent low. The first sign of something new happening on Thursday is going to be an hourly close above 1768 on the VIX. Looking at the S&P 500 cash index, we had an early warning signal pullback. The pressure zone started to develop. We moved up, another early warning signal. So far, we've been able to trade through that. On Thursday, the first sign of something new happening is going to be an hourly close below 2061.01. An hourly close at 10:30, 11:30, 12:30, 1:30, 2:30, 3:30. That would give us a new intraday sell signal. Our next target to the upside, and we'll probably hit this on Thursday, is 2078.13 and then 2093.75. You can see above that we've got 2109 and then 2125. That's the next target on the daily chart. So we've got three targets between where we are right now and our target on the daily chart for the S&P 500 cash index. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation, and that is all for me for this week. Next time you'll hear my voice is next Tuesday morning. So have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you again next week.